My sister Kalyani is a sensitive person with a big heart. Even when we were children, she fed all the stray cats and dogs down our road in the night so that the neighbors wouldn't scold her for the mess. When she opened her little boutique in the village, she used her income to help women who need small loans. In those days, it didn't matter because she was married and didn't need her own income. But since her husband died in the war, Kalyani lives with me and my family. When the government passed the law to have 25% of women in local government, I wasn't sure it was a good idea. As a policeman, I see how terrible life is for women. I feel that women need protection. That is why even in parliament, only 6% are women. I was surprised when our village nominated Kalyani as a contestant to enter the Pradesh Sabha. And I got a bit scared when she got the seat. Only 3 other women were elected. The rest of the councillors are all influential men. On days that the Pradesh Sabha convened, Kalyani and a few women from our village would always sit under the mango tree in my garden and talk. Their stories were never good. Either men in the councils didn't let her speak, or they made inappropriate comments to embarrass her. Sometimes I feel angry that I can't protect her. We even had a big fight when I asked her to just stay at home and manage her business. After 2 days of not talking to me, Kalyani said she is going to join the Will Club. I didn't like this idea in the start. Usually a club is a place where people drink and dance. I found out that the Will Club is set up by Search for Common Ground and Grameen Foundation, together with the Jaffna Social Action Centre, Affected Women's Forum and Women's Resource Centre across the districts of Jaffna, Ampara and Kurunegala. I didn't mind her joining this club since it was all women. I heard that only women leaders were invited to join. Businesswomen, political leaders and even women who ran social organizations. But before they had a meeting in my village, COVID-19 started spreading and there was a lockdown. The people who set up the Will Club started having online meetings. Kalyani borrowed my wife's smartphone to join their Zoom meetings. I found this very funny. My sister can't find her own mobile phone in her handbag and never answers it when it rings. It was like watching a funny video on YouTube when Kalyani was learning how to use Zoom. But she didn't give up. Even though we laughed, every week she listened to their meetings and workshops. I also listened to some of the programs. I was interested in Women, Peace and Security Agenda workshops because I thought as a police officer, it was my job to provide security. Soon I started to understand that Kalyani had the power to improve the lives of women and make them independent. As a woman with a business and an elected leader, she could change the lives of women who didn't have males in their families. I didn't tell anyone this, but I started to feel proud of my sister. When the lockdowns were lifted, she started closing the shop and going to have conversations with people in our village. She said it was important to have these meetings to understand what they expect from her as a leader. Other women from the Will Club would join her and these became big events. Sometimes she had these meetings outside her shop. Just like her, I think all the others in the Will Clubs also started talking to their communities about women, peace and security and the rights of women and girls. Sometimes even respected men in our village, like the Grama Niladari, came for these meetings. She invited me to speak about how the police can help women who face domestic and gender-based violence at one of the meetings. 1 year after the lockdown, Kalyani was able to hire our neighbor Daya to work in her shop. I thought Kalyani would neglect her business because of how busy she became. But my wife said Kalyani learned about accounting, how to create a business model, how to apply for small loans online, and even how to conduct an online meeting through Will Club trainings during the day. All her hard work has also brought some results. I started seeing more people under the mango tree in my garden on the days they have council meetings. Slowly, even the male council members started coming to talk to her after the meetings. I thought they were visiting her with a hidden agenda or to make fun of her. I even went outside and listened to their conversations, but they were all agreeing with what she was saying. I don't know how she did it, but in 2 years, my sister changed. She is not the same girl who was afraid of our neighbors. Although she has been through a lot of difficult times in life, she has managed to become confident and gain everyone's support. She has become an important part of our community. People come to my home looking for Kalyani Akka and not me.